world, the Lord is come. Letter. Oh! Hey, friends! I'm putting on the finishing touches on my Christmas tree. Check out this cute ornament. My grandma gave it to me when I was a little girl. It brings me so much happiness when I look at it. I know you may think it's a silly pickle, but it reminds me of the time we made deep-fried pickles together. Yum. Oh, stop! I can see those faces. They are good! While I finish up the tree, let's worship God. I know, it's missing something. Well, maybe a star? Another pickle, maybe. Yes, that might be it.
Jingle bells, special delivery from Grace.
Thank you, Kyle. I wonder what it could be this time. Last time, I got amazing gingerbread men. They were delicious. let me go ahead and see what's inside. Of course! This was what I needed! Lights for the tree! That's what was missing! Huh. I wonder if she knew that I was missing lights. Am I that predictable? Oh, they're kind of tangled. Why don't we check in with Grace while I go ahead and fix these?
Lily, looks like you got yourself into a pickle. Get it? A pickle? Because anyway, I'm so glad you like the lights. Now, let me ask you a question. Do you enjoy looking at Christmas lights? Yes, me too. Now, share with someone your favorite memory of enjoying Christmas lights. That's awesome. My family and I enjoy riding around neighborhoods looking at the lights. In the darkness, the lights just brighten up the night sky. The lights just bring me so much joy. So, why do we hang Christmas lights on our houses and trees? Do you know that the first Christmas lights were actually candles? Sounds dangerous, right? Very much so. I definitely do not recommend decorating your houses and trees with candles. But people used the lights as a reminder that Jesus is the light of the world. You see, before Jesus came to the earth, the world was dark. There was a lot of sin, and people needed a savior. That is when God sent Jesus to earth to fill that need. Jesus brought light and hope and joy into the world. And that is definitely something to celebrate. Back to you, Lily.
Wow, Grace, thank you so much. I will definitely look at lights differently from now on. Speaking of lights, I got them untangled. Sort of. Anyway, now I just need to put them on the tree. Maybe Kyle can help. Kyle! Huh? Kyle? I don't know what's happening. I've gotten myself in quite a pickle here and I can't seem to turn them on.
Okay, time to illuminate you if I can. There it goes.
Aha! Oh, well, look how pretty they are! Wow, Kyle, you're an electrician genius! They're so beautiful! How can you be sad when you have pretty lights? And, there! Perfect! Aren't they pretty? Oh, they're just so beautiful! I mean, what was dark and boring is now bright and beautiful. Friends, Christmas time brings lots of happiness. But if we're honest, most of that happiness is based off things. Christmas decorations, parties, gifts, food. And spending time with family, of course. Brownies, you know, that's important. But those things often go away after Christmas. We pack up all the decorations and eat all the food and nothing's left. Your new toy becomes an old one. Things of this world aren't made to make us happy forever. But the joy Jesus brings is eternal. That means it goes on forever. Joy isn't based off things of this world that die and get destroyed, but it's based on Jesus' love for us, and that is why we celebrate. Jesus came to bring joy to the world. Ooh, I think I heard the big idea. Jesus came to bring joy to the world. Yes, say it with me. Jesus came to bring joy to the world. Eternal joy. We can have all the joy inside us. It is a matter of being connected to one another, kind of like the lights. Oh, let's practice our memory verse. It is found in Luke 2:14. It reads, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." Luke 2:14. Wow, that is a great verse to remember. It praises God and promises us peace if we are walking with him. Let's add some motions. Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those whom his favor rests. Luke 2:14. Awesome. Keep practicing the verse. Let's go ahead and pray. God, thank you so much for sending our son Jesus, and thank you for giving us the gift of eternal joy. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, now it's time for your favorite part of the day, this week's challenge. This week's challenge is to ask a parent to take you out to see Christmas lights or to enjoy the lights on your own Christmas tree. Share why we decorate our house and why Jesus came to Earth. Have a great time. Maybe I'll see you out there. Bye-bye.